Hello friends, welcome to Science Land. I am Nikita and today we are going to talk about an interesting topic, which is drug discovery and development. Now, this particular lecture will be an overview, but I will make sure that I talk about the same topic in depth in my other videos. So, let's start. The process of discovering a new drug is highly regulated because of one main reason: public health concern. You cannot bring a novel drug from a lab to the market and give it just like that to the patient. The entire process needs to be regulated, it needs to be validated, and it needs to be approved by some regulatory body. So, essentially, there are two stages of developing a novel drug. The first is drug discovery. You discover a new drug itself. Second, drug development. Whatever probable potential drug you have discovered, you develop it further. These two stages are further divided into few steps, which I'll be talking about in a minute. Now, generally talking, the entire process is time consuming, it is an expensive process, and it is complex. Now, to discover a drug is not so simple like you'll discover it within 12 months or maybe 2 years. A lot of effort is actually put, and that also when you don't know whether the same drug which you're working on will actually land up in market or no. Because maybe you have discovered a new drug, you have developed a new drug, and maybe it is showing, you know, positive result in animals. But in the last stage, in human trials, maybe it would not show the desired effect. Maybe it is very toxic. So any problem can come. You don't know whether it is actually going to land up in market. You don't know whether it is going to be approved. So a lot of time is spent on a particular molecule, which might be a probable drug. Money. Now, this is the least figure I'm saying you, which is 800 million euros. Because it's definitely more than that, and 60% of this amount is actually dedicated to develop a new drug, and the entire process is very complicated. It is not as simple as we think it is. So let's talk about the process in depth. There are 6 steps. The first, target identification. Now, before you even think of discovering a new drug, you will obviously think of the disease, right? What actually causes a disease? Maybe it's a genetic disease. So you will come up with the conclusion saying, okay, this particular gene which is defective might be the cause of the disease. Or this protein which might be the probable cause of the disease, right? So you identify the target. Target is any gene or protein which is involved in the disease and which causes the disease. So that is the first step, target identification. Second step, target validation. Now, suppose you are studying a disease. You have shortlisted, let's say, 5 genes for a particular disease. Maybe out of 5, only 1 gene is actually involved in the disease. The rest 4 genes are not even closely related to the disease, maybe. So you need to validate whatever targets you have shortlisted that are actually involved in the disease. At the same time, you check for the druggability. Now, druggability is a term wherein you check the binding capacity to the drug. The same thing needs to be done beforehand, because if it is not binding, it will not give you the desired effect to maybe stop the disease or to reverse the disease or to just reduce the intensity of the disease. So binding is very important aspect to check in the first stage itself. Next step, lead identification. Now, let's say there is a library which has many compounds in it. You choose which lead is actually binding successfully to the target of yours. If it is binding, you can go further with the lead. Lead compound is any substance which has the greatest potential to bind to the identified target successfully. Simple. Next step, lead optimization. Now, once you have shortlisted the lead compound, you optimize it. Maybe that particular structure is not safe enough. Maybe the efficacy is not good enough. So those certain things are studied, and the lead, the structure of the lead is optimized accordingly. So these four steps form the stage one of discovering a new drug, which is drug discovery. The next step is animal trials. Once you have the lead, you check what the drug is actually doing in a living system, whether it is curing the disease, whether it is safe, whether it is efficient. All these parameters you will check in animal. But animal trials are also not so simple as we think it is, like take a, you know, laboratory mouse and just check the drug. No, there are certain factors which you need to study, like pharmacokinetics, pharmacodynamic, lot of things we need to study in animal itself. And it's not that you study it in a guinea pig or a rat and you're done with it. No, there are different animals which you need to test on. Maybe you start with the guinea pig, then you test it on rabbits, then maybe monkeys, and then ultimately you give it to humans, wherein the sixth step comes, human trials. Now, human trials also you are not giving to the general public. You are, you know, doing the trial of the drug with respect to dosage. A little bit of dose you decide and you give it to the particular volunteer, and then you check how effective it is. The lead is tested in animals first and then humans to ascertain its properties. We don't know how a drug will react in a living system or in a living being. That's why you have to do so much of trials before giving it to the general public. So that's the overview of the entire process of discovering the new drug. And if you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.